Neighborhood Health Watch is sponsored by the doctors of HCA Virginia.
In today's Neighborhood Health Watch, we're talking about dry drowning or secondary drowning. If you're like most parents, you probably figure once your child is done swimming or playing in the water, the risk of drowning is over. But dry and secondary drowning can happen hours after your child has toweled off and moved on to other things. Dr. Azhar Talibi from Chippenham and Johnston-Willis Hospitals joins me now to talk more about this. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Tell us a little bit about dry and secondary drowning. Are they the same thing or two different things?
Well, they're two different things that are often the terms are used interchangeably. Okay. Strictly speaking, dry drowning is a phenomenon where water gets inhaled into the mouth, hits the vocal cords, and the larynx, the upper airway, will go into spasm, and therefore it makes it hard for the child to breathe. Secondary drowning is a different phenomenon where water gets inhaled into the lungs, a small amount, not a huge amount. The child may sputter or cough, but gets out of the pool. After a few minutes of resting, they seem like they're okay. And then the symptoms of inflammation from that water in the lungs can then get worse over the next 24 hours.
Well, you just touched on some of the symptoms. What should parents do if they see some of these symptoms? And especially if the doctor, you can't get to the doctor right away, what should parents do right then?
Well, the symptoms that we're looking out for are going to be a lot of coughing and sputtering right away. It tells you that the child may have inhaled some water into his lungs and may not have, but then he may be fine afterwards. So later on in the day, even after you've gone home and you dried off, a lot of coughing, difficulty breathing, respiratory distress, vomiting, fevers, any change in mental status where the child's not acting normally might mean that he's not getting enough oxygen. So what do you do? Usually at that point, there's not much that I can do in the doctor's office. Probably it's okay to call your doctor and check in on them, but really that's where they need to go to the ER.
Okay.
Yeah, they might need chest x-rays, IV fluids, maybe some other supportive care.
Is there anything parents can do to prevent this?
Well, water safety is always key. Now, dry and secondary drownings account for maybe 1 to 2% of drownings in general. So they're relatively rare, but drownings are still fairly common, especially this season. So water safety, constant supervision, even in small bodies of water, even the bathtub, you know, they always say. And then getting kids in swim lessons early.
Okay.
Some experts recommend as young as 6 months to 3 years, but definitely by age 4 is a good time to get them into water safety swimming lessons.
Okay, and we'll have more of this on our website, nbc12.com. Thanks so much for joining us.
All right, thank you. So